This medical video has been sponsored by Get the Best Grades with the Least Amount of Effort. Don't just study harder, study smarter. The speed study system can be used by anyone to get better grades in less time and with less effort for any discipline you're trying to learn. Have you ever wondered why students that are dumber than you are getting better grades? Well, it's because you were never properly taught how to study efficiently. Check out this course on the link below for more information. I'm sure you'll find something useful. Get ready, guys. So this medical minute is about imaging of thoracolumbar spine in blunt trauma. And interestingly enough, we have Canadian rules about doing neck nexus criteria and things like that for neck. We have Canadian rules for head scan, but nobody's really come with a clinical pathway for back. And you would think, well, you know, if they're hurting, we'll x-ray. But surprisingly to me, when this article got discussed, is that exam is not sufficient. The sensitivity to pick up not just fractures, but clinically significant fractures is about 40%. That means most of the time, 60% of the time, with normal exams, you will miss clinically significant injuries. Actually, 20% of these patients with clinically significant fractures will have a normal physical exam. That means no pain or on palpation of the spine, no step-offs, no neurological findings, not even complaining of back pain, which is really an eye-opening thing. And we're not talking about transverse process fractures, which is the side of the vertebral body, or spinous process fractures. Those are non-significant. You don't do anything about it. Clinical significant means they either need surgery or they need a TSLO vest kind of thing for a fracture of the spine. Actually, 1 in 6 negative thoraco. So even if you didn't use your physical exam and you said, I'm going to x-ray thoracolumbar spine on every old person that had a significant fall injury or whatever, 1 in 6 of normal x-rays will still have a significant fracture. 1 in 6. So sadly for me, this is eye-opening, is that you have to do CT scans of thoracolumbar spine if you go down this pathway. Who are you gonna do it? So there's some guidelines. Are they awake and alert? And if you answer no to this question, then you gotta go ahead with imaging. Do they have pain over the spine, any step-offs, deformity, or any neurological findings? If any of those leads to the positive pathway, then you gotta image them. And are there more than 60 years of age with a significant trauma? Significant meaning more than a ground level fall, fell off steps, car accident, rollover, whatever. So this is really eye-opening for me. I mean, 60 is not that old. A 61-year-old with no back pain after a significant motor vehicle collision with or without pain needs a CT thoracolumbar. That's a practice-changing guideline for me anyway, where I would have done my exam, and if they have no pain, be done. I wouldn't even have x-ray, much less CT scan them. So this is an initial study and guideline recommendations. They have to do prospective evaluation on the study, meaning now that they've determined these rules, they have to go and do the next 100 patients and follow the guidelines to see if they actually pick up what they want to pick up. But it's still something to be aware of. The surprising number is 1 in 6 negative x-rays. So even if you do x-ray, you're still going to miss a significant fracture. So that's it.